Well, now on our top story, members of the Defence Force will get a 1.5% annual pay increase for the next 3 years.
Labor and representatives of the Defence Force have argued that the offer was too low, given it was below the inflation rate. For a government response to this, our political correspondent Lyndal Curtis is speaking with the Assistant Defence Minister Stuart Robert in Canberra.
Robert, welcome to ABC News 24. Is the decision today by the Defence Force Remuneration Tribunal to rubber stamp the offer a real wage cut, as you told me a couple of weeks ago?
Well, the Defence Force Remuneration Tribunal is not a rubber stamp, Lyndal. It's an independent tribunal that can independently make up its own mind. It can agree with the agreed offer between the Commonwealth and the Chief of the Defence Force, or it can disagree and say, come back again. Today, they've agreed that the current offer stands.
And that's 1.5% each year for 3 years, which is below the rate of inflation.
It's 1.5% salary increase each year for the next 3 years, that's right, Lyndal.
And it is below the rate of inflation. And you, a few weeks ago, told us that basic economics will tell us that when wages go up less than prices, it's a real wage cut.
Well, the key here is that our sailors, soldiers, airmen and women will get a pay increase every single year. The independent tribunal has had a good look at it. They've produced some 15-page report going through their rationale for it. They had the opportunity to say, no, government, you are to go back and find a different offer with the military, and they chose to back the current offer that's been agreed between the Chief of the Defence Force and the government.
But the basic point you acknowledged to me, I think, on the 15th of October stands, doesn't it? That basic economics tells you when wages don't go up as much as prices, that is a real pay cut.
Well, Lyndal, in today's environment, where we're borrowing $1 billion a month, where debt is approaching $400 billion in macro gross terms, the government's in a very difficult position. The budget won't balance for a number of years and difficult decisions have to be made. One of them is for wage restraint. Now, as you know, there's been no parliamentary increase in salaries, indeed an extra 2% tax on the top bracket for those high earners in the country.
Although politicians did get, and particularly ministers, did get quite a big pay increase. Not that long ago.
And indeed in 05, 06 and 07 with the General Officer pay grade and the General Other Ranks pay grade called GOPS and GORPS, because the military love acronyms, there was a range of increases in defence salary as well. Now last time we got together I made the point we would love to give our fighting men and women more money, but we can't. We don't have it. We've been left a huge hole by Labor. We've got to fill that in with responsible economic management. 1.5% is as good as I can possibly get at present.
The Defence Force Welfare Association says it's an insultingly low offer and requires condemnation. They're writing to the Prime Minister to ask him to intervene. Is there any way this decision will be reconsidered by the government?
No, and it's being backed up by the independent tribunal. Keeping in mind, it's $634 million is what we're paying out. If we were to increase it, that money would have to be borrowed. And we simply aren't, as a nation in the position to borrow more money.
So there's no way at all that you will increase this offer in the next 3 years?
The agreement, as the independent tribunal has released today, is the final agreement for the next 3 years.
The Defence Force Welfare Association also accuses you of changing your tune from opposition to government. Now, you were critical of a wage offer under Labor that was higher, because you say there was more money for defence around. But is it possible that this can be seen as a breach of trust, that the Defence Forces were expecting better from a coalition?
We would always love to give more, but I can only give what I've got in my hand. And if there's nothing in my hands, there's nothing I can give. Now, I've got to find, with the Minister for Defence and the Cabinet and the Prime Minister, $16 billion to fill the hole Labor left for us. This budget is $3.9 billion more than last budget, $1.5 billion ahead of Labor's estimates. But still, that's $14.5 billion left to find. That's the legacy Labor has left us. That's the situation.
There is and will be much more money going into equipment, which is a bigger cost for defence than wages and salaries. There's not enough for a bit more for the troops?
Well, you go to war and into battle with the gear you've got. I want to make sure that if our fighting men and women go into harm's way, they have the best possible gear, and that certainly is a priority for us.
So that will soak up some of the extra money, or a great proportion of the extra money that defence is getting?
Yes, it will. There's a huge hole we have to fill in the estate, in IT, in capability. That's the legacy Labor left us, and unfortunately that's the hand we're dealt.
How does this fit with Defence Force possibly wanting to recruit more people? Does this make Defence a less attractive place to work?
Not at all, because Defence is a total offer. We say to those coming in, there's a salary, it's generous, there's an enormous number of allowances, there's subsidised housing, there's free ADF healthcare, which we've bought in at a cost of hundreds of millions of dollars. It's a complete package that we offer our people to come and serve in the nation's uniform.
So a wage offer less than the rate of inflation won't make it less attractive?
The current wage offer of 1.5% per annum plus the rest of the benefits that come with the total package, no, will not make it less attractive for people coming to serve and to join the ADF.
And what does it say, given this decision has come out at a time when you are committing troops to the fight in Iraq, although the ground forces, the special forces, haven't gone in yet, that you're making this offer, which has now been approved by the Defence Force Remuneration Tribunal?
It says that Labor gutted the ADF. The adults are back in charge. We're taking a responsible course of action. We'd love to do more, but if my hands are empty, Lyndal, I can't give what I don't have.
Stuart Robert, thank you very much for your time.
Great pleasure.